everyone. My name is Butter Tongsley, fresh from the fridge, and welcome back to another episode of L.A. Noir. We're going to get right into this again, and we're going to see what we can do about solving another case. 6 months later. The Red Lipstick Murder.
All right, gentlemen, take your seats. Let's get this over before
that's
lunch.
That's right, we're the new...
Clyde Rose judge. At the Homicide Squad has decided to take early retirement. We will all miss Floyd and the steely edge he brought to his police work. The department has arranged a wee drink at the Galway Arms to quench the mighty thirst a man gets from 25 years of police work.
Oh, it's him!
Floyd's departure leaves a place at the top table. And the chief has seen fit to promote Cole Phelps from burglary to the homicide desk. Stand up, Phelps. Take a chair.
Look at my suit! Oh!
You're in the major leagues now, Sonny. Rusty Galloway, a fine lawman of the old school, will be taking you under his wing.
What's wrong with Rusty?
Your first case is the murder of a woman, found last night and bearing all the signs of the werewolf. Get out to the scene, lads.
Something's wrong with Rusty. He seems like he's off or something's bothering him. Ah, okay. There we are. Everything's loaded again. So also sorry about last episode being around an hour or more long. I didn't know it was going to take that long to like finish.
Do you have the address?
It's been all over KGPL. It's off Temple Street between Belmont and Glendale.
She wants a five-star. Goddamn.
Anyway, I didn't want to cut out any important like scenes of the episode, so that's why I did edit as much as I was able to.
The cop has solved the big case.
I'd rather you do
that
for
me. My cat's right now biting my arm. Oh, something went wrong, eh?
Real happy to.
Oh, we got a new car. Oh, Tigress, will you calm down? My cat's being playful. She's biting and licking my arm right here. Alright, so how far is this case from us? It's actually not too far. It's really right behind us. If we follow this road, we'll have to take a left off of First Street and onto Second Street in order to get to Glendale Boulevard. I will see you guys when I get to our destination. Be right back.
Any Central unit, car 16.
What happened to Rose?
Parker wants the chief job. Word is it's either going to be him or Thad Green. So they're both clearing the decks.
Where does that leave you, Galloway?
Leaves me saddled with a chump like you, Phelps. I didn't ask for you, and I don't want you, so keep it to yourself. See if you can learn something about seeing how a real cop operates.
What did he mean by the werewolf?
Medallion. The Daily News came out calling him the werewolf killer. The Examiner came up with the Black Dahlia.
Were any closer to catching him?
Not a chance. 6 months and hundreds of guys running down leads, and we got nothing.
You don't think this has anything to do with it?
No, I don't. 90% of murders are domestic, Phelps. Some guy gets into a beef with his wife, he takes it too far. This will be the same. But cutting someone in half and leaving them off the sidewalk, that's a one-off.
Why so many women this year?
Because of the war. You should know that. Guy gets to kill people every day in combat. Comes home, he's expected to take lip from his wife. What do you think's gonna happen?
It's that simple.
Like I said, most of the time it is.
Okay, that was my fault. I accept it. My sorry about that early traffic problem I was having a little bit right there. Also, things were starting to like.
How about a scoop for the Examiner, Galloway? You could use some good press.
Another tramp, another message. Is the werewolf back in business, boys?
Do you have a mother, asshole? A sister? How about showing some respect for this poor woman? Let us do our job, and Detective Galloway will give you a statement later.
He's good, Rusty. He even sounds genuine.
That's Phelps, guys. The war hero. Defending the honor of murdered humps.
You're used to it, Phelps. Moving along, guys. You got your pictures, you got your headlines. Now scram.
I like this guy. Galloway knows how to really get them to back off, especially when we're trying to get them to back off of him. Especially since there's important business here. Okay. I'm gonna have to censor that, and if not, then I'll make sure the video is warned about mature content.
Froman, this your beat?
Yes, sir. Well, part of it. Kids park here, they use it like a lover's lane. It's a working neighborhood. Some trouble, but nothing like this.
Oh, God.
It's known locally as the Moors.
You were first on the scene?
Yes, Detective.
No one's disturbed the body?
No, sir. We cleared out them vulture reporters so Pinker and the coroner could work. They're waiting to talk to you.
Go house to house and see what you come up with.
Oh. What?
What can you tell me about the shoe prints?
Men's size 8s. Pinker lifted impressions for me to compare back at the lab.
Let's check out all the evidence. For a second, I thought this was an arm over here.
The victim's bag? Looks brand new. Can't be the one used on the body.
They used lipstick on the body? I thought that was written in blood. What about this? This is just a brush? Just a brush. Okay. That's just garbage. What the hell? Is this a doorknob?
Looks like some kind of puzzle or parlor game.
Oh, okay. Hold on. I can solve this easy. Okay. Nope, that's good. It won't go down any farther. Okay, I gotta turn it until it matches here. Oh, that's squeaking. No. I can get it, I can get it. Give me a minute. I think it had it. Yep, okay. Got it! Whoa. Oh, that's...
Bomba Club. Why steal a table lighter?
That is cool! That is an awesome lighter! Ah! Alright, so we saw A, B. Is there more that we can find before going about the body? I'm making sure to look in. Anything else? Let's investigate the body. I'm gonna make sure to try to censor it.
Cause of death?
It could be the head injuries. She has been badly stomped. The cuts look super.
What caused the blunt force injury to the face?
Could be anything from a baseball bat to a lug wrench. I'll have more details after the autopsy.
Oh, God, I'm not liking the looks of that. No, tilt the head the other way. Oh, God. The head is cracking. No. Stop. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to flag this for mature content.
What about this wound on the finger?
Something removed. A ring, most likely. I assume it was taken post-mortem.
Anything missing here? Nope.
Hmm. Interesting.
Fuck you, BDT.
What does the writing on the victim mean?
BD, like Dahlia? Tex? Your guess is as good as mine. Could be something to it, or could be the killers trying to throw you off the scent. Either way, I'll run tests on the lipstick.
Any idea of the time of death?
From the temperature, I'd say after midnight. I'll confirm with you later.
Can we get to the bomba? Man could die of thirst in a case like this.
I gotta get to a phone. Oh, alright, there's me. Wait, can we go over this? Yep, okay, we can. I was about to say. Oh, just box. Alright, just a box. Let's get out of here. I don't want to look at that. Oh, thank you. Thanks for watching over the car for me. Night bar and club. No, nightclub and bar. Bleh! What am I saying? How far is it? Oh. That's the location of... That is odd that we got a location of the crime scene all of a sudden highlighted. Oh, that is pretty down there. I'll be right back again. Unless they start talking, I'll make sure, of course, the talking scene is recorded. And hopefully... we'll be close by to when it happens.
The werewolf?
For my money, a copycat.
We can't rule it out. We need to work the evidence.
You'd love that, wouldn't you? A big head to hang on your wall. A caller of the decade. You've been working evidence on BD case for 6 months and got nicks.
There's a difference, Rusty.
Oh, yeah?
I just started working it today.
Okay, hotshot. What's more likely? The werewolf comes back around, leaving us a note on the corpse?
He clearly has a thing for power. Power over women. Why not power over the police department as well?
Let me finish, Phelps. A guy opens his mouth again after 6 months of stoom. Or some opportunist who's been reading about the BD figures, he'll rip off the MO and get himself a freebie.
That's not totally fantastical.
You know, the Examiner and the Daily News might be good at coming up with monikers, but they're terrible for police. There's a reason we didn't get the son of a bitch after the short murder. It was them, locusts.
Where do you think the werewolf killer is now?
Dead by his own hand, stationed somewhere else with the armed forces. San Quentin, another town, another country, who knows? So, Phelps, I understand you want to turn this into a big case, but it doesn't work like that, all right? A case will come and find you. You can't make it something it ain't, understand?
So you don't think the werewolf has continued to operate in the Los Angeles area?
No chance. You would have found him.
Right here? I didn't touch anything. I don't know why those boxes exploded. We were coming in from where the fence is, but okay. Okay. Let's do it. Questioning time. We're gonna focus. We got this. We got this.
Where's that goddamn waitress?
Gentlemen, what can I get you?
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. Were you working here last night?
Yes. How can I help, officer?
You can start with your name.
Garrett Mason.
You're the regular bartender on nights?
I'm a temporary barman. I work for an agency. I fill in at bars across town.
Do you remember a woman who came in here last night? 5'7", about 110 pounds, blonde hair, about 40 years of age.
You mean Celine Henry?
Yes. Do you know anything about her?
I don't. But the owner, Mr. McCall, serves her most nights. Would you like to speak to him?
I would.
He sits at the back of the club. Wears a hibiscus. You can't miss it. Is there anything else?
Inquire away, Phelps. I'll stay here. I'm a little parched. Pour me three fingers of rye.
I just don't know how to dance to bebop.
Since he was wearing a... he's right here.
You want a tip? Refill my coffee next time, honey. Say, honey.
Detective Phelps, LAPD. We're investigating the murder of Celine Henry. Do you know her?
Celine? Oh, Christ. Sure, I know her. She and I and
you
Jacob, her husband, we go way back.
She was here last night?
Sure, she's a regular. Celine is.
Officer.
That's the spirit.
Was a.
Pour me another.
Lovely woman.
Was Mrs. Henry here with anyone last night?
Not at first. Celine already had quite a head start.
But she attracted attention?
Certainly. A few gentlemen became very enamored with her and her stories. One guy in particular.
You know him?
No. He's been in a couple of times.
Did they leave together?
Yes, at around 11. If it helps, I made the guy's license plate.
Let's take a look at this.
I think this could be a great help, sir. Thank you.
To be 8899. All right.
Mrs. Henry appeared to be missing a ring, torn from her finger, but not her wedding finger.
Celine always wore a red garnet ring on the large side. Larger than life, like Celine herself.
Did she have it a long time?
Sure. Since way back in her flying days.
Did her husband buy it for her?
No, it was before Jacob.
Gotta tell us more, man. Come on.
I think you know where the ring came from, and I think you're gonna tell me.
Okay. I bought it years ago. I carried a torch for Celine in those days. Guess I always have. Her old man never knew about it.
You know the husband?
Sure I know Jacob. He was in the Corps. He met Celine on a furlough and married her when the war was finished. Put up with a load of shit.
Do you think he killed his wife?
No. No, not in my opinion.
Like he's telling the truth, but just in case, if I get this wrong, it's my fault. But I feel like he has to tell us a little more, because I feel like there's more to it about putting up with stuff. Like, he said that they were putting up with shit. And he seemed to hesitate for a second there about...
So if it wasn't Jacob, then you probably let her out of here with the guy who killed her. How do you feel about that?
Stole the attitude, will ya? I tried to get onto Jacob. I rang him up. Asked him to come pick her up, like usual. But He refused. And she picked some night to push him over the edge. I rang him back around 11:30, but got no answer.
Thanks, Mr. McColl. You've been a big help. One more thing. Would you have an address for Celine?
142 North Union Avenue. God knows I had to send her home in enough cabs to remember that.
Hey, honey, what time did you get off waiting table?
Where's that goddamn waitress?
So, all right, I got all of them correct. Salad. I'm making sure to be focused.
You ought to meet Joe's buddy. He's nice. Really.
Good thing they have a phone.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, what's the hurry? My stool was just starting to warm up nicely.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a registered owner on a license plate, 2BOY8899.
Yes, Detective. I'll need to contact the DMV. Shall I relay the details via KGPL?
Please. Thanks for your help.
All right. They're ringing a license plate, and we're going to head to our next stop. So let's get in the car. Oh, tell me there's a way. Okay, there isn't. Well, it looks like I'm going to have my first time backing up. Wish me luck. I feel like I'm about to hit that cab coming. If I'm lucky, they're still moving while I'm doing this. Alright, we're going to head to the Henry residence. Where is that? It says it's up ahead. It is nearby. It is nearby the crime scene. I'll see you guys when we get back to the location. But first, let's see how well I can do backing up. Come on. Please, walk a little faster. Okay, you fan yourself for some reason. Hey, I did it.
You find the booze helps you get through a working day?
Sharpens my investigatory instincts, Phelps.
A smart lawyer might use that to throw out anything you collect today.
A smart man might know it's unwise to stand between the patient and his medicine.
As long as you're not falling over, Rusty, I'll let it slide.
That's mighty kind of you, Phelps. You know, you picked the wrong job if a healthy thirst offends you, Cole.
We owe it to this city to do the best we can in this position. As homicide detectives, that responsibility is all the more serious.
Always the politician.
It's not political, it's practical. Maybe the men combing Hollywood Boulevard after the Elizabeth Short murder were more interested in sniffing out booze than the clues that would have led to her killer.
Yeah, well, if only you'd been there, choir boy. Betty Short'd be alive, the Japs would have spared Pearl Harbor. Our ancestors wouldn't have tasted the forbidden fruit.
Minor syntactical error, Detective Galloway. I never claimed to be able to prevent crimes. I only suggested a proficiency in solving them. Guess that's the drink slowing you down.
Oh my God, brother, oh brother. Worse than I could ever have imagined.
I mean, Phelps got a point. I mean, you gotta be top of your game. If you get drunk, you gotta slow down.
Officer needs help. Shots fired. Officer down. 6th Street and Lindley Place. 6th Street and Lindley Place. Unit to handle code 3. Identify.
Here we are. Here's our stop. Henry residence. 11:49 a.m. House could use a fresh coat of paint.
Hey,
I'll try the back door. Wait here a second.
Are we about to see something we shouldn't? Oh. You're supposed to yell out LAPD there. See? You are Rusty. Rusty.
Alright, let's... Side window's been jimmied. Looks like somebody's creeped the joint.
Size nines, above average for a lady.
Size nine heel.
Burglar used a pry bar. Why did you kick the door in?
Think I'm gonna climb through a broken window in a $30 suit? You got another thing coming, Buster.
I mean, I would. Oh, oh. Come on. Ah, da. If you sober up, you can find me.
Selene and Jacob are obviously having problems. It speaks to motive.
Crime scene evidence still weighs against it being the husband, but Jacob could give us something to go on.
If you sober up, you can find me at apartment 2, 1050 Huntley Drive.
One of my exes drank like this, you'd be feeling the back of my hand.
Call in burglary and get technical services out here. I'll talk to the neighbors.
Don't take all day about it, Phelps. I'll get nasty when I'm thirsty.
Nothing significant.
Galloway, homicide, badge number 564. Requesting technical services for a suspected 459 at 142 North Union.
I'm making sure to check out the whole place, because you never know what important things might be here. Oh. Is this important?
I don't think this is going to help us.
Oh, it's just goggles. Looks like swimming goggles. Those are the old type ones too. I actually used to have a pair of those. Hey, and I'm back. Sorry about that. We had groceries. Where was I? Right, investigating a crime scene. Oh.
Tiffany, the rest of this stuff is junk. Might explain the missing ring.
It was also zooming in before that. Anything else?
Not sure this means much.
She has a... Oh. What do we have here?
Regular Amelia Earhart per day. The ring looks distinctive.
Oh, okay, so the goggles wasn't swimming goggles. That must have been like old pair of airline goggles. Okay. Anything in here? Nope. Sure has a lot of booze all over the place. God damn. Think you intoxicate yourself enough there? Is there anything else that we can find? Wrong thing. Nope. I don't see anything else. Unless there's something on the table. Like, we already investigated that. Yeah, there's nothing else here. Nothing else is chiming. All right, let's go and talk to the neighbors. What would be a neighbor that has a good view of that, though? Would have to be... possibly... Let's see what it says here. Case objectives. Canvas the neighbors. I hit the wrong button. Oh, hello.
I knew it wasn't safe around here anymore.
Hello, miss.
LAPD. Are you acquainted with Celine Henry, miss?
Horgan. Jennifer Horgan. I've known Celine for more than 10 years. Our children grew up together. What's going on, officer?
Did you see Mrs. Henry go out last night?
Well, I'm no busybody, you understand, but Celine had been drinking. And she and poor, long-suffering Jacob had a terrible row. I think Jacob may have given her a black eye. He stormed out and she went back inside.
Did he come back?
No. Celine was listening to music and shouting until she left around 10 p.m. She was very drunk to have been driving. But she is not the sort of person you can stop from doing something when her dander is up. What is this about, officer? Is Celine all right?
I'm afraid Mrs. Henry has been murdered, ma'am.
Murdered? Oh, my God. I'm afraid I need to go and then sit down.
Marshall problems. Anything else I can do? No, that's it, Canvas. We're gonna have to go to Jacob's apartment, see what we can find. I think I hear her inside. She's like banging on something.
I brought his socks in it, Brazil.
Let's see what Jacob has to say for himself.
I don't think Jacob is our man, but we should see what he has to say.
Has that just been paid look about him?
See you when we get to our location. Here's our stop.
Okay, Phelps, we go in hard. You follow my lead.
He has the experience being in the homicide desk, so I'm gonna listen to him.
Jacob Henry?
Yeah. Who's asking?
LAPD. You're under arrest for the murder of your wife, Celine Henry.
Murder? Celine?
Save the dramatics.
Oh, my God.
RKO, pal. You got bigger problems.
What the hell are you talking about? You come in here, you tell me that Celine is...
Take a seat, Mr. Henry. We're going to have a look around. Then we'll talk.
Jesus. I'm sorry.
Save it.
I get even the slightest hint that you're a flight risk, pal.
Let's look around. Huh?
You think the atmosphere's thick in here? Wait till you try to guess.
Oh. Hello.
He'll be back any moment. Just sit tight.
The oldest problem there is, what to do about the old lady.
Hello.
Size 11s.
Wait, size 11s. We found size 8 shoe prints. I think someone's trying to throw us off. What's behind here? Oh wait, no gold doorknob. Anything else we can find? I don't think there's anything else we can find here.
So who could have killed Celine? Where did she go last night, Jacob?
A bar, I suppose. Look, I don't know.
You're definitely lying, because people said that you were there with her.
We get the impression that Celine liked to live the glamorous life. How did she end up with a hump like you, Jacob?
Celine was one of the first woman pilots. She hung out with movie stars and royalty. But
okay,
when she came back here broke and struggling, she married a mechanic. Put a roof over her head, food on the table. Not glamorous, but the best I could do.
God dang it.
I'm not ashamed about that.
I messed up that one. I really wish I could ask the same question.
When did you last see your wife, Mr. Henry?
Last night. I went to see her. We talked. Things got a little out of hand. I left.
All right, that I know we can doubt him on, because things getting out of hand. We were told about a beating and she had a black eye.
And how are we meant to believe that, Jacob? It isn't looking good for you.
That nosy bitch from next door, Janie Horgan. She'll tell you I left. And what time.
Oh, okay, so he was telling the truth. That was my fault.
Why did you kill her, Jacob? Things will go better if you come clean about it.
That's a lousy thing to say. I never gave up on my wife.
This I can doubt him.
You went to her house, you fought, you beat her, she left, and then you followed her.
I left first. She tried to batter me with a frying pan. I had to slap her down.
Understandable.
Okay, what the hell's going on? He was shifting eyes. Saying that he'd never, gave up on her, and his eyes are shifting. Game's trying to psych me out. I see how it is.
So you can prove that you came back here after you left your wife's place.
I came back here. I was here all night. Start work at 6:30. I'm not the going out type.
Did a neighbor see you? Talk to anyone? You need an alibi, Jacob.
I don't have one. I was here. I listened to Amos and Andy on the radio, and then I went to bed.
We're still going to need you to come downtown, Mr. Henry.
We can get this all down on paper, Jacob. How you got fed up with
your
wife.
I got all of them wrong. How?
Kill my own wife?
She was a lush and a tramp, and you just couldn't stand it anymore.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
So now you're gonna tell me you loved her? Ah, the DA goes all gooey over remorse, Jacob.
Oh.
You're not being rational.
What's this bunker?
Call it in and get a squad car dispatched. And check for messages. I'll keep old Slugger here company.
I should have clicked lie about when he said not giving up on the wife. Ah! I want to redo all that because getting it wrong, I feel like it.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need a patrol unit to transport a suspect back to Central.
Certainly, Detective. You have a message from the coroner. Do you wish to be put through?
Yes, ma'am.
Carruthers.
It's Phelps.
I've completed the autopsy. Several wounds to the head from a blunt metal instrument. Closest match would be a socket wrench handle.
So the cause of death was the blunt?
No, the blows to the head surprisingly were not fatal. Death was from hemorrhage and shock from the fractured ribs and multiple injuries caused by the stomping.
Anything else?
He's some kind of sex fiend. The tissues of the anus were bruised about 1/8 of an inch, but no trace of semen in the anus, vagina, or stomach.
Thanks, Doc. Operator, give me R&I. Any word on an owner for that vehicle? License was 2BOY8899?
Yes, Detective. The plate belongs to a brown 1936 Pontiac. Registered owner is one Alonzo Mendez of 402 South Fremont Street, apartment 16.
Thanks. Any other messages?
One, Detective. From Captain Donnelly. He wants any and all suspects returned to Central. Interviews to be set up immediately.
Got it. We're coming in.
I can't believe I got all those questions wrong. All right. Let's go to the Mendez apartment. Where is that located? It's actually not that far from here. Alrighty. Let's get over there. I'm not even on the road.
Alonzo Mendez. Sound like a man who moonlights as the werewolf?
Don't sound like a man I'd let my daughter anywhere near.
You've got a daughter.
Spend enough time drinking, Cole, you'll find yourself with any number of things you don't want when you're sober.
So that's why you never sober up.
Exactly.
Brother said she took a real pounding.
Maybe if he had been a little firmer in the beginning, he wouldn't be in this situation now.
I imagine that Neanderthal routine is a big hit with the ladies, Galloway.
Women love me, Phelps. I have no complexity. They know exactly what they're gonna get.
Our stop is right up ahead. Excuse me, pardon me. Oh, honk yourself. Light was red on your end, too. Number 16.
Mendez, apartment 16.
Alright, let's do this. Being that's apartment 3. Whoa, what?
Here,
The apartment's up on the top floor.
All right, top floor. Up the stairs, okay. There it is, right down the hall.
Don't bother knocking, just kick the door in. Take a look around and see what you can find.
Car key.
It would take a smarter man than me to connect that. Giving me anything to go on. Gotta get these to Ray. Size 8s could help place Mendez at the scene.
Size 8s. And a loaded weapon.
I doubt it.
You doubt it? He has a gun! Oh, then again, people do use it for protection, so... There's something in here? No, there's not. Oh, wait, can I use the phone? Anything else? I don't see anything else. Yeah, there's nothing. Did we really have to kick the door on our way out too? It looks like we're actually gonna be
you know the way.
To the police
you can drive.
Department, so I'm gonna have him drive. There's no police phone and it's not highlighted. All right, and here we are.
We have a firm lead, Captain.
Are you questioning my judgment, Cole Phelps?
No, sir.
Good. I thought not. Jacob Henry is a sub-sister pushed around by his wife. I think with the right kind of persuasion, he might be prepared to seek absolution. Are you prepared to show him the error of his ways, young Phelps?
I don't think he's our man. Galloway agrees with me.
Don't drag me into this.
Rusty is a practical policeman. A bird in hand is always worth two in the bush. Let's liberate a confession from poor Jacob, and the public will sleep easier tonight. Run along now, Phelps. I've warmed him up nicely for you.
Well, at least we'll get to talk to him twice.
I got the jitters again.
Doesn't look good, Jacob. You're in a big jam here. You lie to me, and I can't help you out. Do you understand me?
Yes.
What do you do for work, Jacob?
I'm a mechanic. Engines, differentials, transmissions.
that kind of stuff.
So you have access to tools?
Yes, I do.
Your wife was brutally beaten with a socket wrench handle, then stomped to death. How do you think that looks, Jacob?
I was home in bed.
You gotta tell us more.
You were at home in bed while your wife was putting out to some stranger? What kind of man are you, Jacob,
what?
That you allow that?
Oh, come on!
Son of a bitch. You got no right talking about my wife like that.
What's happening? Is Jacob bad luck or something? Talking to him for some reason, I'm like getting every question wrong.
You did it. Everything points to you. What does Tex mean, Jacob?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I need a reason to
finally.
You want a confession? That's what you want?
That's exactly what we want.
Seems to me there are two types of marriages. First, where the couple love each other equally and everything's roses. And then there's the other, where one person loves the other more than life itself and always puts them first. Chumps like me. Love them no matter what, no matter how badly they behave. That's it. That's my confession. I love my wife. And I'll take any test you got to prove it.
Your marriage was over. You took her in and she threw it back in your face. You didn't go over there to hurt her. It just got out of hand.
It's not how it was.
Okay, now he's lying.
Jacob, I think she pushed you around and slapped you about. You got to like it. Big guy like you, and you're a fucking pushover.
Ah, fuck you. I did my best to make it work.
We heard him talk about how things got out of hand, and now he says that it didn't go like that.
Why did you break into your wife's house, Jacob? Why steal the ring?
What? What are you talking about? I've got a key. Why would I need to break in?
You took the ring because you found out who gave it to her.
What are you talking about?
Her prized garnet ring, given to her by her old boyfriend, Dick McCall.
I never knew that. I lived with that woman for 3 years, and I never knew that. In that case, I think you should be talking to Dick McCall.
We'll do the detective work, Lunkhead. Just answer the questions.
I don't see any way out of this unless you give us something.
Phelps, you failed me, son.
We have another lead, Captain. This guy Mendez could be our man.
I hope so, Phelps. I really hope so. I'm deeply disturbed by your style of police work.
I was doing my best. That's all I can do.
You don't want Jacob? Let's go take Mendez. Somebody's got to swing for this, Phelps.
God dang. Wait, I need a phone. Is there a phone somewhere?
Stripped off me at the grand jury. Case was thrown out. Now the DA wants my head.
I need a phone. I guess I have to go back to the apartment? Alright, I guess I'll see you guys back at the apartment.
You're behind the wheel.
I feel like I'm answering them right, but they're just not giving me a full thing to look on. Or I'm just an idiot. Whoa. Serious music is playing. Okay. Something. like, we saw that the footprint is a size 8, and Mendez is the only one with a size 8, unless it is Dick. If it's Dick McCall... What the fuck? Was that black spot always there? So now we're back here again. There's gotta be something we have to look over. Oh, whoa, whoa, zoom in. Oh, you were...
Carruthers could match the color and brand of the body.
And the socket brush.
Consistent with Celine's injuries, and the blood could be typed.
We have the murder weapon. We better get Pinker down here.
Why keep it? Why not throw it away?
Think these clowns are geniuses? Thank your stars you caught a break. Captain Donald would begin to like you.
Hey! What gives?
LAPD, you're under arrest.
Do not lose that son of a bitch. I'll go get our wheels.
Mendez, stop right there!
Go. You're not getting anywhere, Mendez. Whew. I'm a scaling squirrel.
You don't need to do this, Alonzo.
Get in and drive. Clean this asshole off the road.
Look out! Whoa. Ah, dang it! Come on, come on, come on! No, 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 no! No, 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 no!
I got an idea. Get him next to my window, Cole. Keep me alongside his vehicle, and I'll stop the son of a bitch.
All right. Hope you know what you're doing, Rusty.
Belt, you got to get me closer.
I know! Come on, you almost got him.
Oh. I'll try to shoot out his tire. Wish me luck.
You're under arrest for the murder of Celine Henry. Put your hands where I can see them.
Family of modern times.
Yeah. I should have hit lie though about giving up on his wife thing.
I ain't saying a goddamn thing.
You did a grand job, lads. Phelps, that's quite a way to acquit yourself in your first outing as a homicide investigator. It seems the city has a new and vengeful guardian. Considering the evidence against your suspect and the thoroughness with which a report was compiled, I foresee a safe passage through the courts, and the DA agrees with me. Brutality on a scale such as this deserves retribution. The people and the press of this city demand it.
Huh. We didn't get a drink. I got all the clues, and I got 6 questions wrong. I accept the questions gotten wrong, because I should have hit, lie and all that. Jacob Henry is left to mourn while Mendez waits in lockup for a visit from the DA. Oh, I guess it's just telling us of what happened. I got 4 stars, though. That is a great way to end the case. I got some of the questions wrong, but I still got the job done. In my opinion, I aced that because I did it to the best of my ability.
This pain to cool the lava you pump through my veins, 'cause I'm burning out for you.
What was wrong with him? He was all alone and all that. I don't know. All I know is that is all set. And I actually have to end it here. That was really fun. I enjoyed that case. Like I said, I got some of the questions wrong, but I enjoyed it either way. So I think that's a good time to end the episode off. Thank you all so much for watching. Please leave a like, comment, tell me what you think of the videos. And as always, I will see you in the next videos. Take care.
It's delicious.